Today, we will go over ways to secure your USCIS online account. And make sure to watch until the end because the last tip will help you block 99.9% of automated hacking. A USCIS online account has a lot of benefits. It allows you to file forms online and tracks your case anytime from anywhere. Even if you file via mail, you can still set up an online account and link your case to it later. However, cybercrimes have become more and more common in recent years. With all of the sensitive information in your USCIS online account, it is critical to make sure your account is as secure as possible. The last thing you want during this long journey is to get your identity stolen or compromised. Today, we will go over a few things that you can do to secure your online account. Like always, we include all of the resource links in the video description. Are you ready? Let's go. First, install antivirus and anti-malware programs on your computer. This is the most basic step you need to take. Most of the new computers come with antivirus software, but if you don't have one, there are a few free ones out there, and we will include the link in the description. After installation, there are two tweaks you need to do. First, you need to turn on the automatic virus definition update so that the computer is protected from the latest threats. Second, set up a regular virus scan schedule, such as every week, so that you don't have to remember. Second, do not log into public Wi-Fi networks or computers. Nowadays, we want to be connected online all the time to access our social media, respond to emails, or watch the latest news. With limited cellular data, we all want free public Wi-Fi wherever we go. However, most of the public Wi-Fi connections are not secure. That means hackers can easily hack into these networks and access your information remotely. So, do not log into your USCIS online account in public, whether through a free Wi-Fi network or a shared computer, such as in a hotel. Third, do not click on any links in emails. Phishing emails and text messages may look like they're from a company you know or trust, such as USCIS. The message will often say your account is restricted and try to trick you into clicking on a link or opening an attachment. First, all emails coming from USCIS should end with @uscis.dhs.gov. Second, do not click on any links in emails or text messages. This is clickbait that tries to fool you into thinking it's coming from USCIS when it's really not. The only link you need to click on from USCIS is the very first email when you set up your online account. And again, the email should come from myaccount@uscis.dhs.gov. Fourth, do not share any personal information over the phone. USCIS might call you to ask for availability for an upcoming interview. However, USCIS will not call you to verify your personal information, including your account login and password. When in doubt, hang up and call USCIS back using the official phone number on the uscis.gov website, 1-800-375-5283. Fifth, create complicated passwords for your USCIS online account. First, do not reuse passwords from other websites. Second, create unique passwords that include symbols, numbers, and upper and lowercase letters. If you have weak or reused passwords, all it takes is one in the hands of the wrong person to unlock all of your important accounts and do a lot of damage. One great app that we have been using for years to manage our passwords is Dashlane. We came across Dashlane in 2016 and have been using it ever since. It has truly been life-changing. Dashlane allows you to securely store your passwords and personal information so it's easily accessible. This means you don't have to spend time typing in your passwords, passport info, financial information, or addresses. Dashlane is the secure place to keep all of your accounts and autofills it across all sites with ease. I seriously don't know what I would do without it. To make your digital life easier and safer, try Dashlane for free on your first device by clicking the link on the screen or in our description. Then, if you want to use Dashlane on more than one device, use the code USCitizenshiptest for 50% off. Sixth, set up two-factor authentication for your USCIS online account. Two-factor authentication, also known as 2FA, is an extra layer of security used to make sure that people trying to gain access to an online account are who they say they are. In addition to providing your username and password, you are required to provide an extra piece of information, usually a code, to access the account. By doing that, it is less likely for a hacker to access your account, even if he or she has your username and password. So, how do you turn on the two-factor authentication for your USCIS online account? Let me show you. Just a side note, USCIS calls the method a two-step verification. After you log into your account, click My Account on the upper left. Then choose Settings. It will bring you to the Account Settings page. Click Change Password at the lower right corner. It will bring you to a new page with Edit Account on the top. This page provides quite a few options to secure your account. Let's go over them one by one. The first is your primary email, which is the email address you used to set up your online account. If you want to change it, click Edit. Enter your new email address, and you also need to enter your current password. Then click Update Email. Second is the recovery email. You want to add a recovery email because this will be the backup email that USCIS will use to reset your password if you ever forget it. Click Edit. Add your recovery email, and then click Submit. If you want to update your existing password, you choose Edit for Change Password. It will ask you to enter a new password and confirm your new password. And it will also ask you to verify your current password. Then click Change My Password. Okay, the next one is the two-step verification. This is that extra layer of security that we talked about earlier. Click on Edit on the right-hand side. It will bring you to the next page that gives you three options for verification methods. first is using an authentication app. The most common one is Google Authenticator, and it's available in both the Android App Store and the iOS App Store. It will give you a new 6-digit code every 30 seconds, and you need to use that in addition to your username and password to log into your account. The second one is the SMS text message. This one will send you a code via text message to the phone you set up every time you try to log in. The last option is email. USCIS will send you a code to your email every time you try to log in. In our example, we will choose email. Once you choose your option, click Submit. On the top, it will say, "Your 2-step verification method has been set. Please confirm that it works." You will receive the code depending on the option you chose. In our case, we will go into our email and retrieve the code from the email that USCIS sent us, then copy and paste it into the Secure Verification Code field and click Submit. If the code is correct, you will see 2-step verification successful on the upper left corner. From now on, every time you need to log into your account, you need to enter the code in addition to your username and password. Now let me show you the remaining things you can adjust on this page. Mobile phone. If you have selected SMS text message as your 2-step verification method, this phone will receive your verification code every time you try to log in. All you need to do is click Edit, enter your phone number, and click Submit. Next is password reset questions. Click Edit. It will ask you to set 5 security questions. You must remember the answers to these questions if you ever need to reset your password. So choose something that only you know. There's a long list of questions that you can choose from in the drop-down menu. Once you've selected all of your questions and answers, click Submit. Next is backup code. This is the code that you need in case you don't have access to your 2-step verification. If you click on View/Edit, it will show you your current backup code. It will give you the option to export it as a PDF file. You can save the code in a secure location on your computer. Or it also gives you an option to generate a new backup code. If you click that, you will have a new backup code and it shows here. Last one is the account activity. If you click View, it will show you your login activities, including date, time, browser used, and IP address. If you see a device or event that you do not recognize, or you suspect someone else may have your password, then it's time to change your password. All right, that's all we have. Do you have any other questions or security tips that you want to share? We hope these tips give you peace of mind so that you can focus your energy on preparing for your interview. Good luck, and I'll see you next time. Take care.